properties of Darboux sums or properties of Riemann sums. If f is a function from closed interval a comma b to the set of real number is a bounded function and p is a partition belongs to the set of all partition of the closed interval a comma b, then the first point is L of p comma f is less than or equals to u of p comma f. It is true for all partition p belong to script p of a comma b. That is, for a given partition and the given function, upper Riemann sum is always greater than or equals to lower Riemann sum. F is from the closed interval a comma b to the set of real numbers or be a bounded real valued function. Now we will divide the closed interval a comma b into n equal sub intervals. Like first sub interval is I1 from x0 to x1. Second sub interval is the closed interval x1 to x2. And the rth sub interval is the closed sub interval xr minus 1 comma xr and so on. The nth sub interval is the closed sub interval xn minus 1 comma xn. P is a partition which consists of n plus 1 partition points. They are x0 equal to a, comma x1, comma x2, so on, xr minus 1, comma xr, so on, xn is equals to b, b a partition. Partition, we mean a finite ordered set. The points x0, x1, x2, x3, so on, xr minus 1, comma xr, so on, xn are called partition points. The above partition consists of n plus 1 partition points. There are n sub-intervals. The first sub-interval I1 is equals to closed interval x0, x1. The second sub-interval capital I2 is equals to the closed interval x1, x2, so on. The closed interval xr minus 1 comma xr, so on, the closed sub interval xn minus 1 comma xn, where this closed interval xr minus 1 comma xr is known as rth sub interval. Delta r stands for the length of the rth sub interval. That is given by the formula xr minus 1. That is the positive length of the subinterval. The script p of a comma b is called set of all partitions of the closed interval a comma b. Norm p is the maximum length of the subinterval of the partition P. So norm P is defined as maximum of the values xr minus 1 where r is running from 1 to n. If P1 is a subset of P2, then P2 is called finer than P1 or P2 is refinement of P1. If P3 is equals to P1 union P2, then P3 is called a common refinement of P1 and P2. If P1 is a subset of P2, where P1 and P2 are two partitions, then norm of P2 is less than norm of P1. Look at the order here. As far as the set concerned, P2 will be having more number of points or more number of elements than the partition P1, when you go for the norm, norm of P2 is less than norm of P1. For example, if you take P1 is equal to the set containing 1, 3, P2 is the partition containing the points 1, 2, 3. Clearly, every element of P1 is in P2. Therefore, P1 is a subset of P2. Where if you find the distance of P1, that is 1 to 3, that is 3 minus 1 is 2. Whereas we consider P2, which is having 3 partition points, this will have a 2 sub-intervals, namely the closed interval 1, 2 and the closed interval 2, 3. Therefore, if we go for the length, norm P2 will be either 2 minus 1 or 3 minus 2, but both are equal to 1, and hence norm P1 value is 2, norm P2 value is 1, and we know that 2 is greater than 1, and hence norm P2 is less than norm P1. The sum of the length of the given sub-interval, namely sigma delta r, where r is running from 1 to n, is equals to delta 1 plus delta 2 plus delta 3, so on delta n. We know delta 1 is the length of the first sub-interval, which is given by x1 minus x0. Delta 2 is the length of the second sub-interval, that is equal to x2 minus x1. So on delta n is the length of the nth sub-interval, namely xn minus xn minus 1. Here x1 minus x1 get cancelled, x2 minus x2 get cancelled, that is every term get cancelled in pairs except xn and x0. Therefore, we have xn minus x0. Xn is nothing but b, x0 is nothing but a. Therefore, sum of the length of the sub-intervals of the interval a, b is b minus a. Capital M and small m be the supremum and infimum of the function f in the interval, closed interval a, b respectively. Capital MR and small MR be the supremum and infimum of f in the rth sub-interval, namely closed interval xr-1, xr respectively. Sigma r equal to 1 to n capital MR into delta r is equals to capital M1 delta 1 plus capital M2 delta 2, so on, plus capital Mn into delta n, that is equals to U of P, F, and U of P, F is known as upper Riemann sum or upper Darboux sum. And remember that for upper Riemann sum or Darboux sum, we use capital M, uppercase M, uppercase capital M. Capital M stands for supremum. Similarly, sigma r equal to 1 to n small mr into delta r is equals to m1 delta 1 plus m2 delta 2 plus so on plus mn delta n, that is equals to L of P, F, where U of P, F and L of P, F are called upper and lower Darboux sum or Riemann sum respectively. Omega of P, F is equals to U of P, F minus L of P, F. Sometimes we use W also, W or omega or O, for oscillatory sum of the function F corresponding to the partition P. If An less than or equals to K for all N, then we say that AN is bounded above by K. Similarly, if L is less than or equals to AN for all N, then AN is bounded below by L. Small m less than or equal to small mr, less than or equals to capital mr, less than or equal to capital M. If you consider to be, this is small m, that is infimum of the interval a comma b. Capital M is the supremum of the interval a comma b. Therefore, the starting point is m, the end point is capital M, because the increasing order, they consider the increasing function, increasing order. When you come to rth sub interval, remember that r is equal to 1 to n. R represent each and every sub interval of the closed interval a comma b. This point, the value of the function at f of r minus 1 is small mr, and the value of the function at xr, namely f of xr, is capital mr. This interval a to b, this is small m, that is infimum of the interval a comma b. Capital M is the supremum of the interval a comma b. Therefore, the starting point is m, the end point is capital M, because the increasing order r. Integral from a bar to b, f is known as lower Riemann integral, and it is defined as integral a bar to b, f is equals to supremum of L of P comma F, that is also equals to find the supremum, we take limit. Limit N tends to infinity L of P comma F, that also can be defined as limit norm P tends to 0 L of P comma F. When you say norm P tends to 0, the length is almost equal to 0. Integral a to b bar f is equals to upper Riemann integral, and it is defined as integral from a to b bar f is equals to infimum of u of p comma f, that is also defined as limit n tends to infinity u of p comma f, that is equals to limit norm p tends to 0 u of p comma f. Upper Riemann sum of minus f with respect to the partition is equals to minus of lower Riemann sum of the function f with respect to the same partition. Similarly, L of p comma minus f is equal to minus of u of p comma f. Look at the sign and the Riemann sum. Here minus negative of the function, here it is minus of f, here upper becomes lower becomes upper. If f is from closed interval a comma b to r is a bounded function, and p belongs to set of all partitions of the closed interval a comma b, then upf minus lpf is called the oscillatory sum of f corresponding to the partition p. U of p comma f minus L of p comma f is denoted by omega of p comma f, or w of p comma f, or o of p comma f. If p1 and p2 are any two partitions of the closed interval a comma b, and p1 is contained in p2, that is p2 is finer than p1, then we have the following results. The first one is u of p2 less or equal to u of p1. Again, look at this, look at the changes here, and L of p2 greater than or equals to L of p1. Oscillatory sum of p1 comma f is greater than oscillatory sum of p2 comma f. L of p1 is less than or equal to u of p2, that is no lower sum can exceed any upper sum. It is true for all partitions P1 and P2. If f is a function from close interval a comma b to R and g is another function from the same interval a comma b to R, are two bounded functions and p is any partitions of the interval a comma b, then u of p comma f plus or minus g is less than or equal to u of p comma f plus u of p plus or minus g. L of p comma f plus or minus g is greater than or equal to L of p comma f plus L of p comma plus or minus g. W of p comma f plus g less than or equal to W of p comma f plus W of p comma g. They are known as algebra of Riemann sums. By definition, integral a to b bar f is equals to infimum of u of p comma f. That is, the upper Riemann sum always gives more value than actually the required value. Therefore, we find the infimum of it. Infimum of it. That is, the lesser value among all the upper Riemann sum. When you remove this infimum, when you drop this infimum, we will be having integral a to b bar f less or equal to u of p comma f for all p belongs to set of all partitions of a comma b. Suppose u of p comma f has 5 values. For example, the values are 1, comma 2, comma 3, comma 4, comma 5. That is, u of p comma f has 5 values, namely 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then what is infimum of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5? Infimum of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 will be 1. And hence, integral a to b bar f will have value 1. If you drop this infimum, then what about u of p comma f? U of p comma f will take either 1 or value 2 or value 3 or value 4 or value 5. But just now we discussed this integral from a to b bar f has value 1. Therefore, 1 will be less than 2. 1 will be less than 3. 1 will be less than 4. 1 will be less than 5. 1 is equals to 1. And hence, when we drop this infimum, we will get less than or equals to. It is true for any partition of the closed interval a comma b. Similarly, integral from a bar to b f, that is lower Riemann integral, is defined as supremum of L of p comma f. That is, L of p comma f always give lesser value than the actual value. So to get the maximum approximate value which is equivalent to the actual value, we take supremum. Therefore, supremum of L of p comma f is equal to this value. That is, integral from a to b f has the maximum value of L of p comma f. When you leave this supremum, when you drop this supremum, when we eliminate the supremum, what happens? Integral from a to b f is greater than or equal to L of p comma f. It is true for all partition. Thus, upper Riemann integral is always less than or equals to upper Riemann sum. Lower Riemann integral is always greater than or equals to lower Riemann sum. Also, upper Riemann integral of minus f is equals to minus of lower Riemann integral. That is integral from a to b bar minus f is minus of integral a bar to b f, and integral a bar to b minus f is equal to minus of integral from a to b bar f. That is up lower Riemann integral. That is lower Riemann integral of minus f is equals to minus of upper Riemann integral of f. And for any partition, upper Riemann integral is always greater than or equals to lower Riemann integral. This is also same as upper dot box sum is always greater than or equals to lower dot box sum.